Why does this sequence go to infinity? I heard the sequence 1 half plus 1 third plus 1 fourth plus 1 fifth dot 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 goes to infinity. Why is that? I really didn't think it would go past like 3 or something. Well, let's go for this. Firstly though, this right here is not a sequence. A sequence is just a list of numbers with commas. This right here is a series because we have a sum, right? 1 half plus 1 third, so on. Secondly, this right here is a very famous series called the harmonic series. And the full version of it is 1 plus 1 half plus 1 third and so on. But we don't have the one here. Anyway, though, this right here still goes to infinity. And I would like to address your concern that this right here does go above 3 because it goes to infinity. So let me show you. Here's a quick note. If we just add 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus dot 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 up to 1 over 31. Of course, this is just a finite amount of fractions. We can add them up regularly, or you can just use summation on 1 from alpha. Let's use n, start with 2 and it ends at 31, and then we have 1 over n. So work this out, whichever way, you'll get approximately 3.027, which is of course above 3. Yeah. And now, let me show you the classic proof that why this right here diverges to infinity. Diverges means that it does not converge to a finite number. All right, check this out. In fact, this right here gives you a little hint. This is almost a power of 2. Right? But anyway though, here's a proof for it. I'm going to start by writing down 1 half plus 1 third plus 1 fourth and then plus 1 fifth. And then I'm going to end up with the next power of 2, which is 1 over 8. And then 1 over 9, and then the next power of 2 is 1 over 16, and then 1 over 17, and then so on. Yeah. So of course, this is the same as that. I just write down like more terms. Now, let's make an observation. 1 half is 1 half. I would like to just keep that. Okay? I'm just going to keep that. But I'm going to look at this and that together. Have a look. We know 1 third is about 0.33. This is about 0.25. This is bigger than that. So I can replace the 1 over 3 as 1 over 4. And I will just make this thing be greater than that. So instead of 1 half plus 1 third, I will be looking at this as 1 half plus 1 over 4. And I'm going to keep the 1 over 4 as how it is. Right, and then next, here's the trick, 1 over 5, well, this right here will be bigger than 1 over 8, right, 0.2, this is 0 point something, but bigger. I will replace this by 1 over 8, and we have a greater than already, so we can legitimately say that this right here, just replace it, and this inequality is true. And in fact, in the middle, we will have a total of 4 of the 1 over 8. I'm just going to keep it as the same fashion. Yeah? And then right here, same thing. What are we going to replace this by? Yeah, you guessed it. 1 over 16. So plus 1 over 16. And then da 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 up to this 1 over 16. And then lastly, this right here is what? 1 over 32. And then so on. All right. Now, here is the beauty of this. I'm going to put on equal sign because we know 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 is just 1 half. So these two together is just 1 half. But we have a first 1 half right here. Yeah. Next, we add this 1 half. Yeah. And then here, remember we have 1 over 5, so that's the first 1 over 8. And next we have 1 over 6, so that will give us another 1 over 8. And then 1 over 7, that will give us another 1 over 8, and then one more 1 over 8. Altogether, we have 4 over 8, right? Just add them up regularly, and of course, that's 1 half. So we add 1 half to it as well. Yeah. And perhaps I will just purposely put down the spacing so that we can see better. Here's the 1 half, plus this right here is 1 half, plus this right here, we also get 1 half. And then you guessed it, this to here, we also end up with 1 half. And then, of course, We can continue, we get 1/2. Have a look. Once we get to here, let's see, this is 1, 2, and the next one is 3, because up to 1/31, 1/32, right? Yeah. In inequality work, check this out. How many 1/2 do we have? This right here keeps on going forever, right? We will have infinitely many 1/2. So of course, when we add infinitely many 1/2, we get infinity. And I just make a note right here, because we have infinitely many halves. We have infinitely many half. Yeah, so as you can see, this harmonic series without the one goes to infinity, and this right here is the classic proof of it. And if you would like to see this from a geometry point of view, I will also show you that as well, so check this out. All right, here we go. So of course, I'm looking at 1/n, which is like 1/x. So I'm going to just take a look at the graph of 1/x like this. This is just y equals 1/x. And I'm going to produce these numbers from this picture. Check this out. I'm going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on, so on, so on. All right? And to get 1/2, this is how you can do it. Just go to the x value 2, and then go up to the y, and there you have it. This right here is 1/2. And because the bottom right here is just width 1, so the area here is just 1/2, yeah? And then next, 1/3, you just go to x value 3, go up, and then make a rectangle. So you can see that, in fact, I will just label this because the area is 1/2, because it's 1 times 1/2. And then this is 1 times 1/3, so this is 1/3, and then 1/4, and then 1/5, and so on, so on, so on. So have a look. We know that 1/2 plus 1/3 plus 1/4, and then plus 1/5, and so on, so on, so on. This right here will be greater than, well, these are the areas of the rectangles, and we can clearly see that we have this part that's sticking out, right? Well, it's going to be greater than if we just have the area under the curve. So if you look at just the blue part right here, the area under the curve in blue, I'm just going to put this down as what? Integral. Yes, starting at 2 to infinity for the function 1/x dx. And how do we do this? Well, we get natural log, and I will just work this out. We get natural log of x, and then we go from 2 to infinity. When we put infinity into natural log, we have ln of infinity, right? Taking a limit, all right? This is just a shorthand notation for that. And then plugging 2, we get this. This is finite, but this right here is what? It's infinity. This right here is about 0.693. Infinity minus this, of course, is infinity, so this right here is infinity. As you can see, these will be adding up to be bigger than infinity. Therefore, this has to be infinity as well. Happy face. Yeah, just like that.